I'm here with fitness expert, boxing trainer, an expert in this business, Roberto Garcia, also known as Rob Garcia and Robert Garcia. Which one do you go by, coach?
I go by Rob Garcia, but you know, I'll come to anything. Just call me what you want. Just don't call me late for dinner.
You work with the biggest MMA superstars, with the biggest boxing champions. You're wearing one of the champion shirts, Kid Chocolate.
Kid Chocolate.
A lot of people wonder, what are the benefits of shadow boxing with weights?
You know, the thing is when you box and you're sparring, you're going to be in 16-ounce gloves. 16 ounces is 1 pound. So we add a little bit of hand weight just so that you can increase and work on that hand speed. You know, and we also use speed cords. We go back and forth between the weights. You know, we don't want to go over 3 pounds, and then the speed cords. And we just continually use that in the shadow boxing, and it quickens the reflexes and just makes you a little bit sharper. You know,
is there a right and a wrong way to do it? Because some schools of thought is that for the joints or the...
Well, the thing is, you don't want to, when you're using these devices, you don't want to overextend on your punches and hyperextend anything. So you want to keep your game short and tight and quick. Remember, when you're doing this, you're working on speed. So in order to be quick, you have to train quick.
Can someone increase their speed, or is it what you're born?
No. Well, what they call, with all the devices and high-tech things that we got nowadays, you can potentialize your speed. And so you get to your proper potential and speed. That's as fast as you can be. Sometimes if you're not using the proper drills, you're not going to find that potential. So you have to use and exhaust different possibilities. You see guys now in the NFL at the combines, people are running 4.3s regularly. It's because of the technology, not that just the guys are getting faster. It's the technology of preparation, making them that quarter of a second, you know, and that means a heck of a lot of money in the NFL when you're just a little bit quicker.
But last question, what's the highest weight, the heaviest weights I should shadow box with?
I wouldn't go over 3 pounds.
3 pounds max.
3 pounds is, yeah.
So 4 pounds, you're already pushing it.
Yeah, you're pushing it.
5 pounds, you're not normal.
Yeah, 5 pounds, you just do rotational stuff and things like that to warm up, but not shadow box.
And if people want to get a hold of you, they want to train with you, where could they go, coach?
They can contact me at wildcardwest.com and find me through Sam, the manager here, and he'll set it up.
There you go. Thank you so much. We appreciate the explanation.
Absolutely.
So 3 pounds, that's the key. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Mike Sitback reporting.